the Bushbaby is going from 65 horsepower to 95 horsepower. 95 horsepower, you ask? What on earth am I talking about? We've been flying our Bushbaby with the Rotax 582 for more than a year. And while I still believe it's a decent engine, it just doesn't have the power to be a good application on the upwards of 300 kilograms Bushbaby, especially at the 5,000 feet elevation we fly from. So we decided it's time to upgrade. A lot of you started guessing what engine we were going to put in. And most guesses were either a 912 UL or 912 ULS. And mostly I replied that no, it isn't either of those, but technically, yes, it's both of those. It's called a 912 Xtra. This is basically a 912 UL with high compression pistons, which ups the compression ratio to match that of the 912 ULS. This takes the horsepower up to 95. Stick around to the end of this video to find out why we picked this engine and what other engines we considered and rejected. But first, let's go fetch the new engine. I'm waiting for my dad to come pick me up, and then we're going to go fetch the new engine. Alright, we've got the engine in the back, we've just picked it up, and now to take it home. We then delivered the engine to Benchmark Aviation in Warmbath to start the installation, while we were still sourcing some needed components. When the 582 was removed, we discovered that the engine swap wasn't as easy as we had hoped. For one, the 912 didn't fit inside the cowling. Another problem was that the front of the cowling was way too low. Because the 582 was mounted inverted, it allowed the cowling to be installed at a very low angle, which is now too low. It's been about 2 weeks since we dropped the Bushbaby off at Walmart's airfield. The Rotax 582 has since been taken off and the 912 has been mounted. I don't think it's been started up yet, but we are on our way to Warmbath to go check up on the progress. While the aircraft was out of action, we thought we might as well remove the starboard wing to have it repainted, since the paint started peeling off. It affected only the one wing, which was previously redone when a previous owner of the Bushbaby had a ground loop and subsequent wing tip strike. So we asked KFA to redo it for us. We also decided to make the luggage bay a bit bigger to match the size of the newer version of the Bushbaby. This meant ripping out the covering and inserting a lightweight floor extension, as well as new back braces. Unfortunately, the day ran out before we could finish, and we will continue next time. Okay, so why did we decide on the 912 Xtra? Other engines we considered were the Rotax 914, the 912 ULS, the 912 UL, the Jabiru 3300, as well as the Jabiru 2200. The first engine to be eliminated from our list was the Rotax 914, which is too heavy and not actually a standard offered option on the Bushbaby. But that didn't matter since it was way too expensive for our budget. The next to go was the Jabiru 3300 120 horsepower engine, which was also too heavy, even more so than the 914. But I have to admit, the idea of a six-cylinder engine in the Bushbaby did get me properly excited. Next, we considered the Jabiru 2280 horsepower engine. At the same installed weight as the Rotax 912 UL 80 horsepower, both these options had some drawbacks. Even though both options add 15 horsepower over the Rotax 582 we had in, they also come with added weight over the lightweight 582, which partially negates the added horsepower. The 912 UL were the better option of the two because of the upwards of 2.5 times more torque to the propeller than the Jabiru because of the reduction drive gearbox. For a smaller budget, however, the Jabiru 2200 would have won out over the more expensive 912 UL. Okay, that only left the 912 ULS. To be honest, this too was slightly beyond our budget. Enter the 912 Xtra, which increases horsepower the same way that Rotax increased the 912 80 horse to the 912 100 horse engine, minus 5 horsepower. All this at virtually the cost of a 912 UL. The matter was settled. Let me know what you think of our choice by leaving a comment below. And watch out for the next episode where we hopefully start the engine and test fly it. I'll also reveal our propeller choice and even more upgrades that we decided to do. Thanks for watching and see you in the next one.